Hey everyone, DC here, and today we'll be looking at digital DM screens. This first one I made in Notion, and there'll be a link to it in the description of this video. In designing a digital DM screen, I thought about what information would I benefit from having quickly available when I'm the DM. And so for me, that was certain rules, having a place for session encounters, an initiative tracker, and a place to keep track of treasure. As you can see here, the first thing I have, conditions and abilities reference at the top. I have conditions, actions in combat, skills and abilities. This is made with the three column block in Notion. And then each one of these is a drop-down list. You just click the triangle. And here's all the conditions in Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition. I copied all this information from the Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition system reference document, which I will also link to in the description of this video. So if I want the whole thing for exhaustion, here it is. Handy reference. Disadvantage on ability checks at level 1, speed halved at level 2, and so on. And sometimes I need to remind myself what actions I can do in combat when I'm running the bad guy. So, can do an attack action, cast a spell, dash, disengage, dodge, help, hide, ready something, search, use, or use an object. And skills and abilities for those times when I want to make a skill check and I just can't think of the ability to use with it. I have it all here. Click wisdom. So animal handling, insight, medicine, perception, survival, all associated with wisdom. Simple drop down into a bullet list. So this top section is where I would continue to put other rules and things that I need to quickly reference. The next section is session encounters. And so these are quick notes about everything the party is going to run into during this session. So here we have an example of an ooze, and I have the description in the fifth brick room. There is an ooze. I could also put its hit points, its armor class. I could include a link to its stat block, or if I use the encounter builder on D&D Beyond, a link to the encounter builder. I'm going to put whatever info I need to efficiently run the encounter in these spaces. Another handy section is the initiative tracker. And here you just type in the number next to the character name. And if you need to move the initiative around, you simply scroll over to the number until these six dots appear. Grab it with the mouse and drag it to where you need it. Next to the initiative tracker, I have a place to keep track of treasure. So you can populate the item name before you start your session, and then whatever character picks it up. So, you know, if someone picks up that cursed rock that talks to them in their sleep, you know what character has that. And the location where it's found. If you have any other notes or things you find important to add about treasure, just hit the plus button here, and it'll create a whole nother row and column for you and put in whatever information you see fit. And finally, below all that, I have a place to put notes, whatever you want to type. Just go ahead and type it. You can add other Notion blocks if you want. Whatever you need to remind yourself that happened during the session, and then copy and paste that into some other log or record that you may keep. And below that is just a instructions on how to run the initiative tracker and link to the system's reference document. Next up in our dynamic digital DM screen tour is Legend Keeper. Legend Keeper is a website for world building and currently in beta. They have this wonderful feature called Whiteboard that I used to create this DM screen. And they also have a blog post about Whiteboard, and in there was a section on building a DM screen, which inspired my DM screen. And I will include a link to Legend Keeper and that blog post in the description of this video. As you can see on the left here, same things as in the Notion build. You have conditions, actions, combat, skills and abilities, encounter notes. And these are just little cards. I click them and bam, here's all the conditions again. Frightened, grappled, and a drop-down list paired with a bulleted list for that. And below these buttons, I have a space for session story. Again, I click on it. It opens the side panel. And this is where I would put any notes I needed of where the party is in the overall story. and then I click the X. I can go back to my board. Now, as you can see on the right-hand side of the screen, I have Molly, which was a character from my stream campaign, The Inspectors, wonderful art by Diana Sousa. And since Molly is a wiki page here, right here on the left, I simply click this to open up a side view of Molly's page. I can put armor class, hit points, whatever notes I want about Molly, and click the X to get rid of it. And below Molly is my encounter from my charity game, Pastry Panic of Pillsbury. Double click. This is a link to the encounter builder on D&D Beyond. And hit points, armor class, whatever information I want about the encounter. And now what I can do is use this empty center area as a play mat. And I can drag these things over and put them in whatever initiative order I want. If you need the actual numbers to appear on the screen, just go down to the bottom here, click the text tool, click any blank space on the screen, type in the number, click the arrow key again to select, and you can move it around freely. You can put it on top of the cards if you want. Whatever is convenient for you for your encounter. Now in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, you notice, just like in the Notion build, I also have space for treasure and notes. So click that. It's just a table for item, character, location found, and then notes for any notes you may have during this session. Now you may be wondering, how do I use Legend Keeper to build all this? Well, it's all explained in their video from their blog post that I will have a link to in the description of this video. But what you do is you go down to the toolbar, you click the wiki. You click here. You can create page, create map, create board, create template for these. These are all pages. So I create page. And we'll call this one extra. And I want to attach it to the DM screen. So I tell it the parent is the DM screen I create. Now I have this thing called extra. I can double click on it. It's a full wiki page. And I can type whatever I want in here. I click over here, and I can change to a glyph that they have available or emoji for whatever I want. And then to add art, you add a block, add image, and then take an image off your computer, and then that's what will appear like you saw from Molly's artwork there. So I can click up here to the left. Just go back to the main DM screen. And now I have this card called Extra. You can also affect its color by clicking the circle down here. And you can change it to whatever color you want. And there's different sizes. This is considered the medium. The small makes it into a little square. And the large makes it into what I have, the encounter card for Pillsbury. And then you are free to move these around wherever you want on screen. So if it's more useful to have these line up across the top or the bottom or just right in the middle, wherever you feel free. Personally, I like having a playmat area. So if I had more of these, I would run them along the side or the bottom border. And finally, on our tour of digital DM screens is the Stream Deck Plus. In the upper left corner, you'll see that I have the Stream Deck Plus itself, below that, the Stream Deck Plus software, and to the right, the web page. This is very easy. All you do is go to the system website, drag the website over, you put in the URL in the URL box, title it what you want, and if I hit the conditions button, let's pop up the URL. You notice I go to the conditions page on D&D Beyond using the basic rules. Skill list, bam, I'm going to the skill list. And once again, the abilities. I go to the abilities. Now also you may notice I have a little music icon down there. And if I activated Sirenscape, I could control Sirenscape's volume with this as well and just turn the knob up and down as needed. So that's three different ways to make a digital DM screen. Once again, I'm DC. You can find me just about everywhere under DC Lasair. That's DC LASAIR. If you like this video, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave a comment below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.